Music Skyview Network, sponsored by Terry Lambert Hyundai.
We have pretty cloudy days this week. Also, some showers possible tomorrow, with those rain chances increasing by the end of this week, and that could impact some travel plans. I'll break down all the details coming right up.
Right now, it is Channel 6 at 4. Safety concerns at the James Brown Arena. What we know so far about an incident that left a worker dead.
Plus, we can expect temperatures to drop across the CSRA and what that means for people without a place to stay warm, where they can go in Augusta.
And a nationwide turkey shortage causing the prices of the Thanksgiving bird to go up. How that's going to impact the holidays is your news at 4 starts now.
Live from Television Park, this is WJBF News Channel 6 at 4.
Everyone, I'm Jenny Montgomery.
I'm Brad Means. We do thank you for joining us. Coverage you can count on begins tonight in Richmond County.
One person is behind bars following a homicide. Investigators say 40-year-old Angela Burley was arrested and charged with the murder of 46-year-old Ahem Jabri Hill. It happened Sunday around noon on Tulloch's Hill Road. That's right off Glen Hills Drive. Police say Hill was shot and taken to Augusta University Medical Center, where he later died. An autopsy has been scheduled. And the Saluda County Coroner's Office reports finding a body in the Mineta area near a pond Saturday afternoon. The body of 22-year-old Zani T. Cyrus of Ridge Spring was discovered. The coroner's office and the Saluda County Sheriff's Office, along with SLED, are investigating. An autopsy will be scheduled early this week in Newberry.
The death of an employee at the James Brown Arena on Friday is still under investigation. The coroner says 66-year-old Rex Broadwater was pronounced dead at the scene. There was going to be a show there Friday night. They canceled it. Several concert goers were back at the arena today trying to get refunds, and we asked them if they're comfortable going to the James Brown Arena now.
No, I'm not going back to James Brown Arena. I told my wife we have to find another venue. I'm not going back to the Serene. I just have confidence in the facility and what the facility can support, and being a safety issue like that now.
Coroner Mark Bowen says it could be weeks before autopsy results are known. The next event that's scheduled at the JBA is December 14th.
Turning to other news now, the North Augusta City Council is set to meet this afternoon. Several items on their agenda include a construction contract for the Pole Branch Watershed Project. Town leaders are also expected to discuss state and local COVID funds. The meeting starts at 6 o'clock tonight on the third floor of the municipal building. That's on Georgia Avenue for anyone who wants to go. Time now for a first check of the forecast.
Meteorologist Jenna Petracci joining us now on a pretty Monday.
Yeah, we've had beautiful blue skies throughout the day today. Just some high-level clouds were starting to move in from the south. So as we go into the evening hours today, we'll start to see more and more cloud cover. But right now on our Terry Lambert Hyundai Skyview Cam in North Augusta, plenty of sunshine for the rest of this afternoon. Temperatures are also warming up to very nice conditions. 60 in Augusta, 61 in Barnwell. Louisville at 64, 57 in Aiken, a little bit cooler over there. Also seeing those mid to upper 50s anywhere from Edgefield into Lincolnton, Crawfordville, and Gibson as well. So a pretty mild day. Temperatures are definitely much warmer than they were yesterday, seeing a 12-degree temperature increase in Augusta, 10 degrees warmer now in Aiken. And we'll continue to see those temperatures rise by a couple degrees each day this week. We also have a lot of dry air in place. There's high pressure with the dry and cool conditions. Dew points are in the teens, anywhere from Edgefield up into Crawfordville, McCormick, a little bit higher in Augusta, and a little bit more humidity further south where they're seeing some of the cloud cover. Just like you can see now on satellite and radar, no rain though, just some scattered shower activity off the coast near Savannah and down and near the Florida Peninsula. But as I mentioned, high pressure is over our area, with just some showers down in Louisiana and Texas as well. So no rain for us this evening, just the building clouds. Temperatures will stay around 60 by 5 o'clock, dropping into those upper 40s by 8 p.m. Now, it won't be nearly as cold as it was this morning, and that's thanks to the clouds sticking around overnight. A few showers are possible on Tuesday, once again warming up each day. We'll also have more rain possible starting Thursday and continuing into the first half of the weekend. So I'll have those details coming up shortly, but back to you, Jenny.
All right, thank you so much, Jenna. This time of year brings frigid temperatures, and local community centers are opening up as warming shelters for the homeless. News Channel 6's Bria Smith has more.
Bay Park is one of those places that we've adopted as our home for our warming shelters.
It's the second time this week May Park Community Center opened its doors.
The good thing is that there's a need, and that need has been fulfilled.
Guests are given a blanket, a cot to sleep on, a hygiene kit, and snacks and water to get through the night.
Folks who need access to one place, whether they're homeless or just maybe down in the luck with their utility bills, can come down to May Park.
The center opened up Sunday evening and operates as a shelter until 9 the next morning.
Our street encampment team has been going out and letting folks know this service is available to them as well.
And though it was announced as a women's shelter, there is room for all.
There's an area for men, there's an area for women and women with children. We're not turning anyone away.
The Richmond County Commission is working on making sure this can be a more frequent service to those in need. Commissioner Johnson says they want to make sure they're using these centers for all things.
May Park is just that place, and it has been for so long. So I'm grateful for the staff here at May Park, and I'm grateful for the community for banding together to make this happen.
If you are out on the streets and cold, May Parks can help provide you with a warm space. In Augusta, Bria Smith, WJBF, News Channel 6.
Cold temperatures this morning did not stop folks from coming out to get their free turkey. The James Brown Family Foundation has been doing this for 31 years. Hundreds of cars lined up today to get their turkey and other Thanksgiving goodies. James Brown's daughter, Deanna Brown Thomas, tells us it means a lot to her family to carry on this tradition.
It was something that he did because he never forgot where he came from. He grew up very poor, and he knew what it was like not to have that basic need, which was food. So he started doing this, and we're just so thankful that because of great sponsors, because of great volunteers right here in this community, we take care of our own.
Around 200 turkeys were given away to people who pre-registered, as well as a box of food from Golden Harvest Food Bank.
With Thanksgiving coming up this week, many people are running around shopping for their holiday feast staples, but the options may look a little different this year. The owner of Lanier's Fresh Meat Market says they're experiencing a shortage of turkey wings. And at Mount Sinai Missionary Baptist Church, the Thanksgiving food drive, chicken was handed out instead of turkey. Shoppers say food prices are too expensive as well.
They say the turkey has doubled in prices. So it's a shortage on those two.
It ain't just turkeys, it's everything, like the chitlins, the hog maws, everything. The cost of everything done went up super, super high. Like, and then it's hard for us that's on fixed income that don't get food stamps and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? Assistance, it's hard. That's a lot coming out your pocket.
While some Thanksgiving dinners may look different this year, local organizations and churches are doing what they can to make the holiday memorable for everyone.
Well, we've reached the time of year when a lot of people think about giving to others. There's at least one thing you can give without emptying your pockets. News Channel 6's Tiffany Hobbs has more.
This time of year, experts say the need for blood donations increases. That's why they say giving blood can be the greatest gift of all.
With the holidays upon us, people are busy, and blood donations are falling off. At the same time, blood donations are needed now more than ever.
It's such an important time to donate blood because we're facing a tremendous shortage across the United States. We actually need blood or blood products every 2 seconds in this nation.
In the CSRA, Shepherd Community Blood Center is offering a delicious incentive to interested donors.
This year, we are giving donors a free turkey or ham when they donate with us, either in one of our centers or with one of our mobile drives.
Carol says that blood donated at Shepherd has a huge local impact.
Blood donated here at Shepherd does save local lives, and we support 29 hospitals in the CSRA.
You can donate blood at any of Shepherd's locations or at their mobile units. For more information on how you can save a life, visit us at WJBF.com. In Augusta, Tiffany Hobbs, WJBF, News Channel 6.
Coming up on News Channel 6, the runoff election in Georgia getting closer, and today we found out that there is going to be an extra day to vote in that race between Warnock and Walker.
We'll tell you when and where you can go to the polls when we come back. Stay with us.
We'll be right back.
traditional to whimsical, we've got the style you need with hundreds of value-priced products to choose from. Visit CarolinaPottery.com or a store near you.
Welcome back, everybody. On Friday, a Georgia judge granted counties the option of Saturday
p.m.
If you want to hear and comment Senator Warnock yourself, you have a chance to do so today. He's going to be in Wrightsville, Georgia. That's in Johnson County. It's also the hometown of challenger Herschel Walker. Warnock's going to spend time at Doc Kemp School starting at 6:30. His campaign trail took him to Atlanta yesterday.
Meanwhile, Walker will take his Evict Warnock bus tour to Milton today. Walker's last few stops have included Georgia Brian Kemp campaigning alongside him. This as Kemp spends months steering clear of his ticket mate. And now the joint appearance shows how Kemp can help determine whether Walker can unseat Warnock in the December 6th runoff. Yesterday, Kemp told a few hundred supporters standing in the parking lot of a gun store in suburban Atlanta, quote, "We cannot rest on our laurels, everyone." This event will take place at 5 o'clock.
Coming up, a look at the forecast for the rest of this holiday week.
Plus, a major snowstorm with more than 6 feet of snow taking a toll on upstate New York. That story when we come back.
I'm attorney.
Now, your most accurate forecast with WJBF Live Viper 6.
Well, we ended the weekend with a lot of cloud cover, and now we're starting the week with sunshine. It's been a beautiful day. Here's a look at our Terry Lambert Hyundai Skyview Cam in downtown Augusta. Just some high-level clouds out towards the south of us. Those will begin to move in later on this evening. But for now, until the sun sets, we will have clear conditions. And the sun has helped our temperatures warm up nicely today. We started out in the mid-20s, but we're already at 60 degrees in Augusta and Evans, seeing those mid-50s in our northwestern counties. Sandersville sitting at 59, 61 in Millen, 63 in Sylvania. And notice those southern counties from Wrightsville over to Allendale starting to see more cloud cover, and that'll continue to push towards the north. But for the majority of the area, it's a very dry day. We have high pressure keeping us with this dry and cool air mass, keeping relative humidity very low, anywhere from around 20 to 35%, just higher values from Bamberg over into Swainsboro. So as I mentioned, satellite and radar showing those clouds beginning to push in from the south. This is from a disturbance along the coastline, seeing some showers mostly out to sea as well. But this high pressure is really what's impacting us. There's also some rain over in Louisiana and Texas, but that won't be impacting us either. Just that disturbance off the coast will bring us the chance of some showers tomorrow, but for the most part, just the clouds for your Tuesday forecast. Temperatures will be warmer than they were today, though, going up to around 62 degrees is the high, and the clouds tonight will also keep our low temperatures on the warmer side. So no more 20s this week. Today was the last day of that. 40 degrees as our low tomorrow. So getting back to around average and then going all the way up into the upper 40s on Friday. And that will be because of a lot of dense cloud cover heading our way. Our high temperatures aren't going to be changing as drastically. We'll see mostly the mid 60s. Pretty seasonable, only a couple degrees below average, so at least we'll be out of those 50s, so not quite as cold. And as we go into the following week, that's when we may have a chance of seeing a 70-degree day or two. But for rain chances, only 20% tomorrow, back to dry, but cloudy conditions on Wednesday. Isolated showers possible once again for the holiday, and then for Black Friday, it does look like it could get pretty messy outside. We'll have a system moving in. Right now, keeping rain chances pretty low, around 30 to 40% into the weekend, since there's still a lot of uncertainty there. But be sure to stay with us throughout the week as we'll have updates with that. But right now, 3 days away until Thanksgiving, only that 20% chance of showers. Once again, it will be very cloudy outside, though, 65 degrees as our high. So a nice mild day. And for tonight, notice those clouds continue to push in. We're going to have our moisture increase. And by Tuesday, that's when we could potentially have some showers. But overall, we do still have a lot of that dry air in place. So it'll be hard to see a lot of measurable rain tomorrow, but possibly that light rain throughout the day Tuesday, not getting a break from the clouds all the way into a Thursday and Friday as well. For tonight, we'll see upper 30s in our northern counties, a little bit warmer the further south you go, and warming up into the low 60s tomorrow, 62 in Augusta, Aiken at 60. Your 10-day forecast looking pretty mild when it comes to the temperatures. No more super cold nights. We also have some rain in the forecast. Most of that will be on Black Friday and into the first half of the weekend.
All right. Thank you so much, Jenna.
Jenna, yep. Thanks. What? urgent concerns in parts of upstate New York, where the weight of more than 6 feet of snow is taking its toll on homes and businesses. They've seen as much as 6 inches an hour falling up there. Roofs collapsing, people snowed into their homes, roads shut down. At least 3 people have died. You're looking at images showing the extent of the accumulation. The governor says it's one for the record books, no question. Coming up, this could get you in the Christmas spirit. One of WJBF News Channel 6's reporters is in a movie that is going to premiere this weekend.
We will have her story for you right after the break. Stay with us.
Okay, thank you. Bye.
999.
Christmas is going to be here before we know it, and this weekend, News Channel 6's Tiffany Hobbs is going to be seen on the Hallmark Channel.
Our Kim Vicker spoke with Tiffany about her upcoming movie, A Holiday Spectacular.
I started primarily as a dancer, so I was in ballet, tap, and jazz class at Carol Wilson Dance Studio from 3 years old here in Augusta.
Tiffany Hobbs has been performing her entire life. She has an extensive resume of television, film, and live stage performances. Beginning as a dancer, she went on to Davidson Fine Arts, where she began to explore theater and music.
I had 30 minutes of an elective time to fill in for my class schedule, and I decided to take drama because my mom always said that I was a drama queen.
Hobbs went on to study theater in college. In 2015, she went to New York, where she landed the role of Shenzi in the National Broadway tour of The Lion King.
I had $500 to my name, and I said, I'm just going to try it out and see what happens. And I just got so fortunate that I got into The Lion King, and then that took me to a lot of places.
In 2018, Hobbs was cast as Keisha in the TV series Atlanta, starring Donald Glover. She says it was a wonderful experience.
The minute I walked on set, and I remember Donald was just like sitting in a chair, like leaning back, so cool, calm, and collected. And he was like, hey, you want a Skittle? Because he was eating Skittles, and I was like, yes, I would love a Skittle.
Now, this weekend, Hobbs will appear in the television premiere of A Holiday Spectacular on the Hallmark Channel. She plays Alice, an aging Rockette, trying to decide what her next step in life will be. She says her mother, who she took to the movie's premiere, was very excited when she got the role.
My mom would watch them, and she would always say, I just want you to do a holiday movie with Hallmark. And I would just always be like, oh, Mom, okay.
In August, she decided to return to her hometown and her roots by joining the WJBF news team. She says her mother encouraged that decision, too.
She said, I want you to do a Hallmark movie, I want you in a soap opera, and I really think you'd be great on broadcast news. So, it's just funny like how these things, you know, your parents know you very well, sometimes better than you know yourself.
Oh, Tiffany, congratulations. We are so proud of you and so happy for you and your sweet family.
Holiday Spectacular will premiere this Sunday on the Hallmark Channel at 8 p.m. And, you know, I kept saying, she's going to be on the Jenny Show tomorrow.
Yep.
So watch the Jenny Show at 12:30 and see more with Tiffany and her interesting journey.
A great interview tomorrow at 12:30 right here on News Channel 6. For now, more coverage you can count on coming up next at 4:30.
Dee Griffin will be here after the break.